So I'm going to be talking about animal care, equine, agriculture, and countryside courses. So our land-based department. I can see we've got a steady number of attendees, so I will start in just a moment. Feel free. I can see some of you are saying hello. Some of you are interested in animal care. Some of you are not sure between animal care or agriculture. I can see we've got some equine learners quite interested in our equine courses, which is great. I'll be going through all of those and I will start the presentation now in a second. Fab, fantastic. So I'm just going to give some of your comments a like just so that you know we can see them. So I'll be starting the presentation now. So I'm going to start the presentation. Hopefully you can all see this. You're in the right area if you're asking about animal care, equine or agriculture courses. So well done and welcome. We've got you here for about 20 minutes. I'm going to go through some of the courses that we offer. I'm going to talk through some of our facilities. And like I say, there is a chat room that is open. So before we start, a little bit of housekeeping. So there are subtitles available, and if you would like, you can have these subtitles in Welsh as well. I'm going to be talking about our courses and how you can apply online. I'll give you some information on what our courses look like, so the structure of our courses and what it is like to learn with us. And then I'll tour our campus by showing you some of our land-based facilities. Like I say, the chat room is open, it's completely active. I have three moderators here to answer all of your questions, and there's no such thing as a silly question. Okay, so a little bit of background. We have four departments under the land-based departments, so four areas of animal care and countryside studies. So we've got our animal care department, our equine department, our agriculture department, and our countryside department. We run courses from level one all the way through to level three. We also run HE courses. So in terms of progression, learners can stay with us after level three and attend one of our higher education courses. We're running a higher education open evening on the 10th of November. So if you're interested in some of our university level courses or even vet nursing, then definitely check out that open event. We also run a variety of part-time courses or short courses as they're known, and you can find those on our website. What I would say is if you're not sure which course you're interested in at the moment, definitely check out our website. You can find out some of the modules on each course, and you can also find out the entry requirements for each course. So it is based on your previous qualifications as to which level course you would start at. Okay, in terms of when you join us, so if you do enroll on a course with us, our courses are considered full-time, but full-time courses are actually only 3.5 days a week, which is great. It gives you a chance to gain some work experience in those days that you're not in college. You would come on our course and do a lot of your subject area modules. So you will study things like behavior, biology, anatomy, physiology, woodland management, depending on the course that you're interested in. Your course will also consist of GCSE English and math sessions. And the idea is we really aim for students to leave College Gwent with a C grade in those areas. You'll also do some Welsh back while you're with us, which is really good because it teaches you study skills, researching techniques, and we do focus Welsh back on the land-based industry. Another kind of area of your course would be tutorial. So tutorial is when you spend some quality time with your tutor, and that is a good chance for checking your progress, setting any targets for your course, as well as gaining access to pastoral support such as counselling services or any kind of additional academic support you may need. And during tutorial, we also cover enrichment activities. So learning about the environment, for example, would be one of them. in terms of the team in the land-based department, we've got Helen Morgan, who is our head of school, and Helen is one of the people that is moderating the conversation, so the live Q&A tonight. We've got Mitchell, who is in charge of all of our resources at the Animal Care, Equine and Farm departments. Mitchell is also present in our Q&A. In terms of tutors and lecturers at the department, you can see here in our main areas, so our animal care department, from left to right, we've got Jess, which is me. I'm the level one tutor, and then it goes through to Nicole, who's level two, Laura, level three, Sean, level three, year two, and so on. Our tutors cover a variety of subjects. So we have specialists in zoology. We have local farmers that teach for us. In our equine department, in the middle row there, you can see some of our equine lecturers. And we have lecturers that are qualified BHS coaches. They're also eventing and dressage coaches. And we do have an on-site BHS examiner. For our countryside and agriculture department, there on the bottom row, we have NPTC assessors who can assess learners in chainsaws, vet meds, ATVs, spreaders and sprayers. A lot of these are local farmers as well. We have a horticulture specialist, and then we have an ecology and countryside specialist. You may well recognize some of these tutors as well as your Welsh back teachers. So in terms of our resources, what is it going to look like if you come to our department? In terms of our animal care centre, so our animal care learners, we have a purpose-built building or animal care centre that houses around 50 species of domestic and exotic animals. And you can see some of our residents on this presentation. So we have a small mammal room, we have a reptile room, we have an outside area, and then we have some hoof stock. So in our small mammal room, for example, we have sugar gliders, and you can see Apollo on the slide eating his watermelon. We have African pygmy hedgehogs, daegus, chinchillas, mice, hamsters. In terms of our reptile room, we have, including our geckos that are on the slide here, we have an 11-foot boa constrictor, we have a bosque monitor, tree frogs, and then some learners are not fond of these animals, but we have scorpions and tarantulas, as well as giant African land snails. In our outside areas, we have rabbits, guinea pigs and ferrets. Our rescue donkeys are on this slide, so that is Bill and Ben. They come from the donkey sanctuary. And we also have, which you can see here, the Blue Cross Rehoming Centre. So if you do join a course with us, don't be surprised if you end up adopting one of our cats. In terms of our equine centre, so we have a 16 stable equine centre. We have both an indoor and outdoor arena. We also have a cross-country schooling area, and we are very proud to be a BHS approved centre and training centre, which means a lot of learners have the opportunity to complete their BHS exams stages 1 to 4 with us. We also hold a lot of on-site events and competitions that learners can get involved with as well. So our farm and countryside estate at the college, we work with an on-site commercial dairy farm that has around 250 Holstein cattle. Learners also help us to manage a small flock of lowland sheep. Especially during lambing time, learners do help significantly with lambing. We also have a 70-acre woodland that learners in the countryside department help us to manage. And we have a 600-acre as of agricultural land. The campus itself is based on the River Usk, and it's where we get our name. And the Birthing Brook runs directly through the campus. And sometimes you're lucky enough to see otters. We do run a lot of short courses as well on the farm, and some of those you might be interested in and can see on our website. In terms of the learner feedback from our courses, you can find this on some of our social media, as well as on the Colleagues website. But our learners really do enjoy coming with us. And you can see some of the feedback says that it is very real world learning. So we do equip you and prepare you for employment in the land-based industry. We give you the skills needed and necessary, and you also have the opportunity to gain additional qualifications for the world of work.